not it. That's not good at all. Yeah, let's try something new. Da 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 boppy boop skeet skirt deedly. Oops. My bad. I'm just trying to get the nerves out. Splish, splash, sploosh, bing, bong, sing, song. Damn. Okay. I don't know about that last one either, but they say the third time's a charm, right? A three, a two, a one.
Hello and welcome back to another edition of Three Takes. I'm your host, Andrew Gamberdelvin III, and without further ado, let's get right into our underdog pick of the day. Our underdog pick of the day today is going to be Giants versus the Washington football team. Washington football team is -3.5 here, and that's plus odds, which is crazy to me. So take the Washington football team more than they're going to win by more than 3.5 points. So take them -4.5. That'll definitely be the underdog pick. You'll definitely get probably around +125 for that pick. But Washington has lost their starting quarterback for half the year, and that's all the more reason to take them because they're going to be playing for their backup. They're going to be playing with heart, and they're going to show at home on Thursday night on national television that they're playing for their starting quarterback going down, and they they're just playing for him, and that's more than the Giants have going for them. The Giants look terrible week one at home against the Broncos. It looks like they have no life, no lead. I could be shocked here. I'm a big Giants fan, as y'all know, but I'm out. The line will not be able to block Washington whatsoever. Chase Young and Montez Sweat will be on Daniel Jones before he even has time to say hello there. It's terrible. But take Washington, take them with the points, take them -4. And my first pick of the day has got to be with the NFL. It's my way too overreaction of NFL week one. And that's got to be that my way overreaction of week one is that the Rams are the best team in the NFC. I think the Rams, my overtaking bet of I think the Rams are going to make the Super Bowl. I think they're that talented. I think Stafford puts them over the top. I don't think Goff was ever a good quarterback. So I'm taking the Rams to the Super Bowl. That's my overreaction after week one. Rams to the Super Bowl. Which is not much of an overreaction, I'm going to take the Chiefs. Patrick Mahomes is Patrick Mahomes in the playoffs. I know you need a pass rush, but I think his line can withstand it this year. Their defense seems to just make big plays when need be. So Chiefs Rams is my guess for. Actually, you know what? That's too simple. We're gonna go Chargers Rams, right? Herbert, I also think, is an incredible quarterback, and they have a defense that Joey Bosa, Derwin James is back. Yeah, Rams Chargers. You know what? That is my overreaction from Week One. Rams Chargers. My second take of the day is I might be the worst fantasy player in the world. I finished 0-5 this week. Luck was not on my side. Lost Gus Edwards before the year in a lot of leagues. J.K. Dobbins in one league that drafted way too early. And I had Dobbins. Jerry Jeudy goes down. Jerry Jeudy I had in 3 out of the 5 leagues, and Jeudy was my big pick of the year. That was my guy for the year. I just think he's uber talented. So fantasy football, maybe not my thing. After all, I thought I was pretty good at it, but after this week being 0-5, I'm gonna overreact and say that no, you know what? I will make the playoffs in every league, every single league. You know what? We're gonna put that good juju out into the world. Good energy only. Take number 3, switch it up, and we're going to F1. F1, Formula 1, I haven't watched much of F1, but the rivalry forming between Max Verstappen of the Red Bull team and Sir Lewis Hamilton of Mercedes. I mean, Sir Lewis Hamilton has won the past 4 years, past four F1 titles. And it seems like the F1 and everything is trying to make him win again. That's what it seems like to me. They're penalizing Verstappen and every time they both crash together, it looks like Verstappen is getting the short end of the stick. But that is something to tune in for F1 fans. Stay with it. That is incredible. F1's getting interesting to me, just with the rivalry that's forming with the two guys at the top. One of the best races in F1 for the year that I've seen in the past 5 years. It's just been all Lewis Hamilton of recent memory. And then for our money tip of the day, if you're not interested at all in doing your own research and looking and handling your own portfolio, there are plenty of good financial advisors out there. So doing your research to have a good financial advisor take care of your hard-earned dollars, that is something you really can't beat. So I would look into financial advisement if finances really isn't your thing and isn't something that you're willing to put time and energy into it, because everything that you need to do well in, you need to put time and energy into it. So that's it for me today. Arrivederci, Belize, and have a great day.